Everyone, it's me, Alfred, and I wanted to give a quick introduction to the next segment of video that you're going to see. What I've done is I've managed to digitize old video footage, as you've been watching, and I've been documenting the equipment that I've been using and giving you a little bit of an overview of the type of content that you're going to be seeing. Now, what I found was a video from 1984. This is an old stinker. I mean, we're talking about 22 years ago. I had done a short segment on television. It was for Tri-State Cable. It was broadcast in the New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut areas. And basically, the video was based on the introduction of the Apple Lisa computer. Now, for some of you who don't know what Lisa was with regard to the Apple product line, it was the predecessor to the Macintosh. It was a $10,000 system, and it basically encapsulated a Windows-based, you know, graphical user interface with icons and scalable fonts and whatnot, and a mouse. Now, before the Lisa, everyone was using pretty much, you know, DOS-based machines, which when you boot up a DOS system, you get the letter C and a greater than sign. I mean, that's it. That's the interface. Or Apple IIs were pretty much the popular product, and when you turned that machine on, it booted, you know, Apple's disk operating system, and it gave you a bracket, which was basically the prompt for Apple's, you know, basic programming language. So no one ever saw anything like this before. Matter of fact, I first saw the Lisa not even at an Apple-related function, because I was a dealer. It was like just a small trade show in New York City that I had attended, and I saw this thing, and I'm like, what the F is this? And the thing that really blew me away is that imaging on the printer, traditionally we had dot matrix printers. It had an 8x8 matrix that it would kind of hit the pins onto the ribbon and create a character. Well, the Lisa system drove this matrix printer in a graphic mode, so it wasn't restricted to the fonts that were built into the printer. It actually would just image anything graphically at a low-level graphic level. I mean, it was incredible. So what you're going to see is a segment I had done. I think it was about 15 minutes. I'm going to edit it down and just so you can see the whole, you know, the core part of it. And it was done in association with the school district, because the dealership that I worked for, we actually held the Board of Education contract. So all the New York City schools, the Board of Education, came through the dealership that I worked for, Sonicraft Corporation, to buy all their computer equipment. It was quite a contract. It was quite a deal. And we certainly had a lot of fun. It was fantastic business. One other side note on this video segment is that I had done it 2 weeks after fairly extensive surgical reconstruction on my face. I had an accident when I was about 10, 11 years old. I fell off a bicycle. The handlebars gave way, and I went face first into the concrete. My nose took the whole blow, and it was pretty effed up. And the techniques were based, it was called pyramidal reconstruction, so they reconstructed the area so it looked like it supposed to look. But they used lasers, which was, it was cutting edge technology back in 84. They used lasers to seal the capillaries to reduce the bleeding, the swelling, and, you know, usually when someone has that type of work done, they look like they get hit by a 2x4. So you're going to see me stuffed in a suit, in a three-piece suit with a vest. You're going to see me 2 weeks post-surgery. So my face is pretty puffed out, and you're going to see what the hell type of haircut I had. Holy crap. All right? So strap in and watch me demonstrate the Lisa computer. You have no idea how many phone calls I got. People were just blown away. Because remember, you have to put this in the right perspective. No one ever saw anything like this before. This was an early, early introduction of this, certainly to at least the people in the Board of Education. So enjoy the Lisa clip. I look forward to your comments. To my subscribers, I thank you. I really appreciate the trail of comments, and I really try to answer all the comments back and keep it as an interactive type of thing. And I love all you guys and gals. It's great stuff. I'm having a lot of fun. I'm glad you're all enjoying the content. And okay, let's go back in time. You ready?
In our studio today, we have a representative from Sonicraft Corporation here to talk to us regarding new technology. Let's welcome Al de Blasi from Zonacraft.
Hi, Gladys.
Hi. He's the director of the computer division.
Right.
Could you tell us a little bit about the brand new machines that you brought here today, about their names, Lisa and Mac, which are unusual to begin with, as well as what they can do?
Well, the whole thing with the Lisa product line is that it's very, very easy to use. Lisa works the way you do at your desk. The machine kind of simulates your desktop in that environment, and it provides a natural interface, a natural method of doing things for the person using the machine. Apple has done a lot of extensive testing, and a person can get to use the Lisa and master its basic functions within 45 minutes to an hour. So it's a real breakthrough, and we're really excited about it.
I think it's a breakthrough for people like school people who normally would be hesitant to go into learning about computers because we felt that it was something for technicians to be doing and not people that are working with normally their mind and their hands and with paper and pencil.
Well, I agree. Well, people that are in a school environment or any environment, they shouldn't have to know how to use a computer. They should just do it, you know, so they can get their work done. They're meant to be as productivity tools so they can spend more time being productive at what they're good at and not learning how to use a computer.
I totally agree with that statement. Could you show us the machine and what the Lisa can do?
I'd love to.
Okay, let's go. Here we are sitting in front of the Lisa 2. Al, could you tell us a little bit about the hardware?
Sure. This is the Lisa 2.5 system. The box on the top is the storage device, it's the hard disk drive. This is the Lisa itself. I have an area here for a new Sony 3.5-inch floppy disk. Here is what the disk looks like. This little diskette will hold 400,000 typed characters of information. The hard disk will hold 5 million. Here's my keyboard, which has a coiled cord so I can put it in my lap. And to the right of me is the most innovative thing of Lisa, the mouse. The mouse is a pointing device. What the mouse really is, it's an upside-down trackball. There's a small ball on the bottom of the mouse, and when we roll the mouse on the table, it moves a pointer on the screen, and that arrow is my pointer that's attached to the mouse. Now, what we're looking at here is my desktop that Lisa is simulating. Okay, these small pictures on the screen are called icons. They're things that I can identify with by looking at them. I have, for example, a picture of a clock and a calculator and a garbage pail and some documents. Over on the top, this is called a pull-down menu. What I do is I point to the word, I hold down the mouse button, and then I pull down to the option that I wish to do. Okay, for example, since Lisa simulates my desk, I can take these icons and I can move them around and kind of make things sloppy on my desk. Okay.
And you're moving them around by pressing the button on the mouse.
All I do is I point to the icon, and then I click the button down, and I can move an icon around. See how I'm moving these? What I can do now is, since my desk is nice and sloppy, I can go up to the housekeeping pull-down menu. I can pull down to the word straighten up icons, and when I release it, Lisa's going to straighten up my desk. Since Lisa simulates the desk, I can put common desktop tools on the desk. For example, I can put this clock on my desk. If you notice in the top right-hand corner, a clock is being prepared. And I can put a calculator on my desk as well. I'll just point to the calculator, and I'll click on it, and it will open it up. So here's my clock and calculator.
And now you could actually
use it as a normal
calculator. Use it as a calculator.
Sure. I can either use my keypad, or I can just use the mouse and point to the things on the screen. Now, if I want to do word processing, I can go to my disk, I can click on it, it's going to open up the disk, and it's going to show me what the contents of the disk are. Now, instead of showing a very complex directory of information, it shows me things I can identify with, like file folders and documents.
And in this system, the disk is called Profile.
That's right. That's the name of the product from Apple. Now, here I have a folder called Lisa Pads. I want to take a look at what's in that folder, so I'll point to the folder, and I'll click on it. It will open up the folder. Here I have Lisa pads. And down here I have pads of paper. I have writing paper, I have a project paper, I have a database paper, I have graphing paper, I have drawing paper, and I have a spreadsheet paper. If I want to do word processing, I point to this pad of paper and I click on it. Lisa will rip off a fresh piece of paper. I can then bring that piece of paper down to my desk and work on it. Now what I've done already is I've ripped off pieces of paper from this pad and I've put them on my desk already. Okay, over here I have my drawing paper, my graphing paper, my calc paper, and over here I've opened up my word processing paper. Let me put the calculator away by clicking on it. I'll let the clock stay here. Let's open up these three pieces of paper. I'm going to group them. I'm going to put a little box around them. Now they're all highlighted. What I do to one will happen to the other three. So let's click on the graphing paper, and you'll see they'll all four of them will open up. So I have my word processing document over here. I have my drawing package over here. I have my graphic package over here, and I have my spreadsheet package over here. They're all going to be loaded into the machine all at once.
Does that mean that you can use those four different functions at the same time?
Yes. All I have to do is simply click on the window, and it will activate it. If you notice, I have the clock running at the same time. I can have the calculator on my desk. I can have up to 16 programs running in Lisa at once. Okay, here I have my four things. Now, let's go to word processing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click onto the word processing window. And Lisa tells me that this is the current window active by giving me what we call handles on these edges of the window. You'll see them come up in a few seconds. Now, what these handles let me do is it lets me resize or change the shape of the window. For example, if I point to this square box down here, I point and click, I can make the window larger. Okay? If I point up here, I can change where the window is. So let's put it up at the top now. Okay. Let me just scroll. The hourglass tells me to wait. Lisa's loading in some things from the hard disk. Okay, here's my document that I was working on. Okay, let's make it a little bit larger. I can just pull it down and make it a little bit larger. So let me continue writing my letter. Now I have the mouse changed from an arrow to a bar. That's called a typing bar. Let me just click over here and continue typing at this point right here. So here's my document. Let's do some editing with it. First of all, I'd like to delete some words. What I do is I take my typing bar, I point to the word I want to delete, I hold the button down, and I drag it over the word. I then go up to the pull-down menu. I go up to edit. I click on it. I pull down to the word cut, normal words like we use in our office. And it's going to cut out that word. Now I want to make it a little bit easier for our viewing audience to see. I'm going to take the mouse.
Could we try that again? I think that was so quick it was hard to see.
Sure. Well, watch what we're going to do. I'm going to drag the mouse on top of the entire document. I'm going to go up to my type style pull down menu, and I'm going to instruct Lisa that I'd like to change the type style to 1/3-inch modern. So now the letters are going to be a little bit bigger.
Okay. That's amazing.
Now I'm also going to tell it that I want the format to be justified on the left and right hand margins. So now it evened out my margin. Now Lisa is going to reproduce exactly what you see on the screen on your printer. It uses a special dot matrix printer called the Image Writer from Apple, and the end product is really beautiful. Let's delete some words again. I drag the mouse over the things I want to delete. I go up to my pull down menu, edit, and I say cut, and it will cut out the word Lisa 2 computer from my document. Now if I'd like to put it back someplace else, I just click where I'd like it to appear and I say paste. It's going to paste it back.
So it kept in memory the word that you just cut out and put it back in.
That's right. What it does is every time you do a cut, it cuts it to a thing called the clipboard. And the clipboard is an icon in the lower right-hand corner of my screen. The clipboard is the convention that allows Lisa to exchange information from one program to another. I can cut from my spreadsheet into my word processor and vice versa. Now, let's undo this cut. I can have Lisa undo the last change I did, and it will get rid of that last thing that I did. Let's scroll through the document. The way I scroll is I grab this elevator, it's a little box, I click on it and I drag it down. That's going to let me scroll through the document. I scrolled a little too far. If I want to insert, I just simply click the button where I want to insert at, and then I type. Oops, let me do it again. And notice Lisa's going to justify the margins as I'm typing. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to shrink this word processing document. I'm going to put it on the side. And let's go to another program. Let's put this right down here. Let's go over to my drawing package now. I'm going to activate a program called Lisa Draw. Lisa Draw is a technical drawing tool. It's used for doing things like ad layouts or architectural design or even, you know, just art. I've clicked on its window and I'm going to resize it now. Let's make it a little bit bigger. I'll just wait for Lisa to finish loading.
Now, each of these programs are resident in the machine.
That's right. Okay. I'm going to make its window large again. I did a little drawing before. This took me about 3 minutes to lay out.
And all those different size letters are part of
the
package?
Yeah, they're part of Lisa. It has a wide variety of fonts. Let's draw a few things and show you how Lisa Draw works. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drag my elevator down so I can have some fresh paper. Over on the left-hand side, I have drawing tools. Over here is my graph paper. If I want to draw a box, I point to the box, I click on it, I go over to my graph paper, I point, click, and drag. And now I'm drawing a box. By holding the button down and moving the mouse, I can change the dimension of the box. Okay? When I'm ready and I like the box the way it is, I just release the mouse. And I've now drawn a box.
Now, how would you put a circle in the box?
I just point to my tool circle. I go over to the middle of the box. I point, click, and drag. And there's my circle. Now, the thing about Lisa Draw, since it's a technical drawing tool, the box and the circle are independent objects. If I click in the middle of the circle, I can pull the circle out.
What's the difference between the Lisa and the Macintosh?
The main difference between Lisa and Mac is that the Lisa will let you run many application programs at one time. Okay, the Mac only lets you run one application program at one time. Let me do a few more things with Lisa Draw. If I want to duplicate that circle, I can go up to Edit and I can say Duplicate. So I made another copy of that circle. I'll make another one. I can shade them in. And as a layout tool, you can just do things that would take you, you know, hours by hand. It really is a fantastic tool.
I know, Al, we're running out of time. Your demonstration is quite unique. The machine is absolutely state-of-the-art equipment. Could you tell us a little bit about, in one brief sentence, the expense of this kind of equipment?
The Lisa 2 computer system starts at an entry price of $3,500. It ranges from $3,500 to $8,000, depending on the software and hardware that you attach to the machine.
I'd like you to come back and talk to us again about more of the new technology. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks, Gladys.